You know, say I love you. I love you. Oh, I love you. Oh, my love, I want you by my side. You know I'll make you laugh. I want you to be happy, oh. Oh, my love, will you stay in my life? I never want you to go away from me. Don't go away from me. I like it that you're happy, baby. Like it that you're happy with me. Like it that you won't be with me. Oh, say now who I can be. Like it that you want to love me. Baby, do you see that I'm so happy? So happy. Say you set for true to me. Oh, and only you will be my lover. Amen. From January till December. Amen. From December till forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Take my hand together. Oh, we will go wherever. Oh, oh, oh. No buts and no babies. Honey, do you see that I'm so happy? So happy. Say you self choose me. And only you I'll call my lover. Amen. From January to December. Amen. From December till
praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The first reading of this wedding is taken from the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 22 and 23, which says, wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. 23, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. This is the word of the Lord.
God bless
you. I will say hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The second reading for this wedding occasion is taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 4, from verses 9 to 12. Ecclesiastes 4:9-12. Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him that is alone when he falleth, for he hath not another to help him up. Again, if two lie together, then they have heat. But how can one be warm alone? And if one prevail against him, two shall withstand him, and a threefold cord is not quickly broken. This is the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. While we have both of you standing with the brothers and the groom's train, I'm going to be taking the exhortation and the challenge. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here before God and this congregation to join this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate established by God before the fall of man, signifying to us the mystical union between Christ and his church. This holy estate, Christ both honored and blessed with his presence at the wedding in Cana of Galilee, where he performed his first miracle. It is also commended of St. Paul to be of great honor among all men. It is not therefore a thing to be rushed into, or undertaken, or instituted lightly to satisfy our carnal lust or appetite, like those that have no understanding, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God, carefully considering the purpose for which matrimony was ordained. Firstly, it was ordained for mutual society, help and comfort that the one ought to have of the other, both in prosperity and adversity, into which holy estates these two persons have come to be joined. Secondly, he was ordained as a remedy against sin and to avoid fornication, that such persons as have not the gifts of abstinence might marry and keep themselves undefiled members of the body of Christ. Thirdly, he was ordained for procreation of children, to be brought up in the fear and in the nature of our God, and to the praise of his holy name. Therefore, if any man can show any just cause why these two may not be lawfully joined together, let him not speak, or else hereafter forever hold his peace. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, I have the groom here standing with the bride, and the brother's train and the groom's train can now have a seat. I'm taking the marriage covenant. I require and charge you both, as you will answer on the day of judgment, when the secrets of our hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any impediment why you may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you may have to confess it. For be it known to you that many who are joined together against legal principles in the word of God are not joined by God, and their matrimony is not lawful. Any impediment? Daniel, will you have, can I have you face each other now? Will you have this woman turn on the microphone? Daniel, will you have this woman as your wedded wife live together according to God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in soundness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for her as long as you both shall live?
I will, by the grace of God.
Amen. Woman, will you have this man as your wedded husband? Live together according to God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony. Will you love him, comfort him, honor him and keep him in soundness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for him as long as you both shall live.
I will, by the grace of God.
Amen. Amen. Now we proceed to the joining and prayer for the union. Now let me say after me, starting from Daniel. Yeah? I, Daniel,
take you, Wumi,
to be my wedded wife,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward, for better, for best,
for richer, for abundance,
in soundness and in health,
to love,
and cherish,
till death do us part,
according to God's holy ordinance,
and thereunto,
I pledge you,
my trust,
Amen. So you are going to hold his hand now. Hold his hand. You say after me, I, Wumi,
take you, Daniel,
to be my wedded husband,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
for better, for best,
for richer, for abundance,
in soundness and in health,
to love and cherish,
till death do us part,
according to God's holy ordinance,
and thereunto,
I pledge you,
my trust,
Amen. Can I have one of that? Can I have the Bible, please? Thank you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In this church, we went first with the Bible, then optional with the ring, depending on the those getting married. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible is the living word of God. It is eternal and is a symbol of all that is pure and holy. The Bible has gone through many persecutions. It has been tried and tested, and yet it stands today giving light to darkness. May this word of God be your refuge at all times.
Amen.
As you apply the word of God, our prayer is that your love for each other will continue to blossom.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Right, so I'll hand over the Bible to you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now you are going to hold the Bible. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Maybe in a horrible laundry session. Hallelujah. So you are going to use the Bible, place it on her right hand while you say after me. Daniel, you say, Wumi, with this holy Bible, which is the word of God, I wed you.
I give you my heart.
And my body.
I share with you.
My love.
And worldly goods.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
And the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
So, Wumi, you are going to say the same thing to Daniel. You say after me. Daniel,
with this holy Bible,
which is the word of God,
I wed you,
I give you my heart,
and my body,
I share with you,
my love,
and worldly goods,
in the name of the Father,
the Son,
and the Holy Ghost,
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, can I have the rings? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
These rings, both of them, they look beautiful. The one for the groom, the one for the bride. But we don't know the process that he went through. We don't know the face of those that made it. We don't know the God that he said. And that's the reason we pray on the ring. I'd like you to stretch your hands, if you would, while you're seated. I'd like you to begin to commit these rings into the hand of God. We dip it into the pool of the blood of Jesus. This ring shall not be subjected to any manipulation. It shall not turn against the groom. It shall not turn against the bride. As this ring is called a ring, so also each one of them shall be united. United in peace, united with love, united with purpose, united in prosperity, in Jesus' name. Amen. Father, we decree that no matter where this ring will have come from, we present it to you even from your heart. This ring will not answer to contrary order.
Amen.
This ring shall not be invoked.
Amen.
This ring shall not be enchanted against.
Amen.
No spell will prosper against this ring.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
It shall not be an evil point of contact.
Amen.
But this ring will bring in prosperity.
Amen.
It shall bring in peace.
Amen.
It shall bring in favor.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
All right, so I hand over the one for the bride to you. And I give you the groom while you exchange the rings. Praise the Lord. Go ahead and exchange the rings. You don't need mine for this time. All right. Well exchanged. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much as Wumi and Daniel have consented together in holy matrimony, I have witnessed the same before God and this congregation. I have pledged their love and loyalty to each other and have declared the same by the joining and the giving of rings. I, therefore, by the authority of God's word and the law of the state of Illinois, United States of America, pronounce that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Daniel, you may now kiss your bride. Hallelujah. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Ihumande. Can you praise the church? Can the church congratulate them? I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Ihumande. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You can now face the altar. Amen. I want to invite the first lady, Reverend Mrs. Abby Wokono, to take the blessings, marriage blessings, praying for the good one. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And please rise up to our feet as we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We thank you, we bless you, because this is the day you might have made.
Yes.
A day for us to rejoice and be glad for the joining together of your daughter and your son in your presence. Lord, be thou exalted. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, with your joining, they've come together according to your word that their two shall be one. Lord, I pray that your grace, the empowerment to live as one in love, in prosperity, and in purpose, Lord, release that grace of strength upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus,
amen.
I soak them in the pool of the blood of Jesus.
Lord of Jesus.
The foundation of the union, I soak in the pool of the blood of Jesus.
Lord of Jesus.
Let that power that is in the blood of Jesus prevail for them,
amen,
in every way,
amen,
in this their union, in their marriage.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The word of God says, no evil weapon formed or fashioned against you shall prosper. I decree in the name of Jesus, all through your life, no evil weapon formed or fashioned against you both will prosper,
amen,
in the name of Jesus. When the enemy shall rise like a flood, the spirit of the living God will arise to raise a standard,
amen,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The word of the Lord says that a man that finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from God. I pray that forever your wife will be a good thing before your husband and before that church, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And because your husband has come forth, that he will forever be favored because he has taken you as his wife, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I decree and declare that it is well with you both and all that pertains to you,
amen,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
You must not make what you see in public a standard in your marriage because you don't know what is going on in private. The Bible says in John chapter 1, verse 1, say, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So when I say make God your standard, what I'm saying in other words is, make the Word of God your standard. Jesus speaking in Matthew 10, 8 and 9, say, and they twain shall be one flesh. So then they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God have joined together, let not man put asunder. Let not man put asunder. When it comes to your marriage, you don't expect any other party to be obedient to this word. You are the one to be obedient to this word. When it says, let no man put asunder, it means the power is within you. You have the ability, the capacity is within you. The man here can be defined as so many things. The man here could be the society. The man here can be the media, the TVs, radio talk shows, the news. It can be social media such as Facebook, TikTok, and all other social medias. The skills that you watch, let not that put asunder. Nothing stays except what you allow. Nothing stays except you allow it to come in. So it means both of you as one have been empowered to stand against anything that is contrary to unity, to stand against anything that is contrary to love, to stand against anything that is contrary to peace. Nothing works unless somebody is working it. We have different kinds of institutions. Both of you are graduates, as a matter of fact, postgraduates. Some of us in the technical world, others in the medical world, praise the Lord. But then, there is no institution for marriage. So in other words, God is the one that oversees it. Anything you allow outside the word of God will begin to grow. But I pray for both of you. May the grace of God empower you.
Amen.
I say, may the grace of God empower you.
Amen.
Why do I say you have the ability? Why do I say you have the power? The Bible says that that one chases 1,000, but two shall put 10,000 to flight. Those of us that are very familiar with mathematics will find out that even geometric progression cannot measure to that. That one chase 1,000 and two put 10,000 to flight. So when both of you are united, even 10,000 cannot stand you, and so shall it be.
Amen.
I thought that amen can be louder.
Amen.
Number two, marriage bring out or may bring out faults in each other. But you must convert those faults to become form. You must fashion your marriage to be like that of Christ and the church. The Bible says in 1 John chapter 4, verse 8, it says, for God is love. And one definition of love is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 7. It says, love bear all things, believe all things, hope all things, endures all things. That is what love is for you. And as long as both of you key in with this word of God, you'll find out that your love will never depreciate.
Amen.
Instead, it will keep blossoming.
Amen.
And so shall it be.
Amen.
So today, without any wasting of time, we thank God for this marriage. We thank God for this blessed union. And we pray as God have joined you together on this 27th day of April 2024, no man shall put any asunder.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Guys, our custom here to take offering for the newlywed. Hallelujah. He's not coming to the church. Can we have a song while we take offering? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Leave your hands into the pocket. Bring out anything that you want to wind in the church before the reception. It's an offering that goes to them. Let's do that quickly. Go ahead.
Baby, I promise you a shoulder to lean on. Darling, I promise you a listening ear to hear all you gotta say. And I don't feel like to you. And I don't feel like to you. Me and you go forever. Amen. Amen. His love for me and you. Amen.
I didn't think you did dance, you did wine. When you cry, I go wipe your eyes. Give me your bag, make a feel like my dough. I'm the only one, you don't need another. I hold you down. You know this, baby. And I've told you now, I'm right there. I'm there for you, baby.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can see everybody's looking very beautiful. By the way, this place looks very gorgeous. It's my first time here tonight, and I can see that Events by Angel did a very wonderful job to create this wonderful event. All right, mommies and daddies, please let's step out. Let's officially welcome you to the party the Nigerian way, the Oahu way, the proper way. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for honoring them. Thank you so much. God bless you, everybody. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now I'm going to flip the baton and switch over to the family of the groom. I want to believe the family of the groom are ready. If you are still a member of the family of the groom, please join them. I'm talking about the families of the Iron Day from Edo State. Please, let's join them quickly so that we can come in and dance in a grand style. Is the family of the groom ready? All right, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the families of the parents of the groom. Let's go, DJ.
They are no longer separate. They are now one. So whether it's the family of the
But I was told to specially invite all the pastors and the ministers of God present here. Daddies and mommies, the Lord, please send you step forward. We have a high table for you right here. All the distinguished pastors and men of God, please let's put our hands together for the men of God. Let's put our hands together for them. Let's clap for them now. The more you clap for men of God, you are increasing your chances of making heaven. Clap for them. So you can make them more easily. That is speaking. That is, we are laughing about it. It's true now. When you clap for men of God, you are increasing your chances. Please celebrate them once again. Celebrate them. Celebrate them. Well, ladies and gentlemen, on this note, I would like to welcome the bride and the groom. But just before then, I'd like to welcome the bridal party. The bridal party consists of very close friends of the bride and then very close friends of the groom. Okay, now let's go!
I'm going
My brother, bring the remaining money. We want to save him later. My sister, please stay on this side. And my brother on the other side. Please, I want to ask you, is there anybody who can volunteer to teach me that? I love the way they shake. Is it like that? My waist, look, I'm too rigid. I need to be flexible. Is my shoulder? My waist. Like this. Ladies and gentlemen, let me speak to my colleague. My colleague is talking on the phone. All right, ladies and gentlemen, what do you think about the last set? Who do you think dances better?
Right.
Team?
Right.
And who is the money speaker? Okay, we see how that's going. Ladies and gentlemen, I saved the best for the last. Hey, I put them on a very high standard. Now they have to show us what they are made of. Ladies and gentlemen, for the last pair of the bridal party, please put your hands together for Abby and Asse.
Yeah.
not busy, can we jam our hands together as we welcome Apostle Vincent Nwokolo as the leaders for the opening prayer. Please celebrate the man of God. Put your hands together for him. Please put your hands together. God bless you, Daddy.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, it's honor to God and the celebration with the new marriage in this and in our Hallelujah. Father, we thank you and we give you praise for a day such as this. We thank you for doing that which money couldn't have. We thank you for doing that which man couldn't give to another. When we see the blessing that is directly from you, we acknowledge it. And that is the reason we say all the glory, all the honor, all adoration be unto you. Father, we commit this celebration, this entire ceremony into your hand. We ask that your spirit take over. Let your presence take prominence. We pray that everything that we do here be to the glory of your name.
Amen.
Lord, we ask that there is no evil emergency, no tragedy,
Amen.
No accident.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I will pray as I've gathered to celebrate. For everyone that have come to celebrate, the days of celebration will not cease in their lives.
Amen.
I will pray, let this be a mark of blessing, even unto the newly married.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
I'm hearing mixed signal. Some people said yes, some people said no. For me, I'm very confident that this man, Mr. Daniel, is very romantic. And he's going to prove that to us tonight. Mr. Daniel, check your microphone. Say hello, Testy. Aha. So, Mr. Daniel, I need you to call your beautiful wife some romantic name tonight. So for every romantic name you call your wife, you take one step. You see, you have a long way to go. You work for it tonight. But don't worry, I'm not going to stress you. Once you give me the first 3-4 romantic names, then I'll ask the audience to help you. I want to believe any one of us present here, we want this marriage to be successful, isn't it?
Yes.
So we have to walk with him together. So but let's start with you. Your people will say, the child that opened his arm is the one that the parents will do what? Carry. So prove to us that he wants us to help you. So give me the first romantic name you want to call that beautiful damsel.
My honey.
Your honey. Ladies and gentlemen, hold on. Let me ask you one name. Ladies and gentlemen, is honey a romantic name?
Yes.
You are 10%. All right, give me the next romantic name you want to call her.
My sweetheart.
Yes.
Sugar water.
Sugar water. Hey, is that romantic?
My queen!
Daddy, will you put your hands together for Daddy? Because Daddy has said that. Hey, Christian, I love that. Queen, the queen of your heart. Is there anybody on this table? Oh, Bobby, Bobby. I like your dress, though. It's good. Can we put your hands together for Mommy's dress? Mommy, is your tailor here in America or Nigeria? I know it. Nigeria is a very beautiful place. We are very fashionable. Thank you. Mommy, please help Mr. Daniel with a romantic name.
My happy.
Hey! Palpitation! Your heartbeat! Okay, Daddy. Daddy wants to help Mr. Daniel. Look at this man that is old enough to call me. He said he's not a daddy. Daddy, I'm a small boy, you are old enough to call me. Alright, tell us, what's the romantic name you should call his wife?
The Sunshine.
Sunshine! Alright, Mr. Daddy, give us the final one, give us the last one. Wait, before you say it, look into our eyes before you say it. As tell us the final romantic name you want to call her tonight.
My own.
Hey! Jesus! Everybody say God when?
God when?
If you are married and you say God when, I'm not here. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. Daniel. So at this junction, we're going to go ahead and cut the wedding cake. Wow, this cake is so emotional. It's in tears. Can't you see it? Let me count. How many tears? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is this?
Almost not back to it.
All right. So, will you please put the knife into the cake? And Mr. Daniel, I know you're a very supportive man. Exactly. Place your hand and support your beautiful wife. Is that a good angle? We can place it exactly. Beautiful. Thank you so much, Groovy. You will know, that's why it's good to hire professionals. Don't just go and hire any other people. Hire people that knows what they are doing. All right, are you ready? All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to cut this cake by spelling the word love. Because I believe this couple, the foundation of their love is based on love. You get it? You say, don't leave me. The foundation of their love is based on love. And then Jesus, which is love. You understand? If you don't get it, thank you. Alright, so we're going to spell the word love. And the last time I checked, when I was in primary school, love was spelled L. That is abbreviation. It's spelled L-O-V-E. So the way we're going to cut it is, we'll chorus each letter, and after the last letter E, they will now chorus the word love. And Mr. and Mrs. Ayonde, when you hear the word love, you can go ahead and call the game. So ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, daddies and mommy, can you give me the first letter L?
L.
And the next letter?
O.
Give me the third letter. Give me the final letter.
E.
And what is that?
Love.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Put your hands together. Okay, now. Enjoy the moment. Mr. Daniel, you sing it with this sound with me. Okay. Would you?
Say,
say, say.
So I promise you my heart and my heart.
Wumi, please, can you cut a piece of the cake? We want to see how you guys are going to feed each other tonight. You might have been feeding him for a long time, but tonight this is the first official feeding exercise. Uh-huh. And it's going to be a romantic one. Paparazzi media team, please, I want you to capture this moment. Not just the feeding part, I want to see maybe something will happen after the feeding. Ladies and gentlemen, please focus your attention right here. DJ, I love that solemnity. I'm enjoying it. So please go ahead and feed this handsome dark man. Everybody say, aww.
Very dark man.
This one is very caring. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are still single, make sure you marry a caring woman. Oh. All right, Mr. Daniel, it's your turn. Please go ahead and feed your wife as well. That's how I went to one wedding. They say it's a Yoruba wedding. So the woman, the lady is married to a white guy. So they told the guy that in our culture in Yoruba, women always kneel down and men do prostrate. The woman wanted to feed the husband on the wedding day. He put the cake in the man's mouth and knelt down. When it was the time for the groom, the white guy, I saw him prostrate. All right, beautiful. Are you guys good? All right, ladies and gentlemen, can we put our hands together for the couple at this juncture? Let's put our hands together. Can we dim the light a little bit? Can we dim the light a little bit, please? Please dim the light a little bit. Thank you.
I'll be right beside you. It's only me that you. If you ever need to.
Anywhere where I want go. If I could, I would love you in my next life. I don't really care about tomorrow. As long as you there right now, I go there fine. You got me here when I low, low. Daddy, you can take my soul. All these things where I did talk right now, I just love my body and bone. Body and soul. It's a vibe and I'm rocking your party. No competition for your side, oh, they know this. Make it look me well, I don't be nervous. Only you, I wanna need nobody, no. Oh, 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 oh.
So baby girl, I hold you down. You know this, baby. And I've told you now, I dare, yeah, I dare for you, baby. I'm gonna be like my body.